Hello, Aishi. How are you?
I'm good, sir. How are you?
Absolutely good. Absolutely good. So, let me first tell the audience about you. Aishi was our student in the year 2019-20, and she is currently studying in IIFT Delhi, batch of 2020-2022, and a wonderful student with wonderful academic profile and a very hardworking girl, I must say. So, seeing this girl, I can definitely say that all those girls out there who think that things are not possible, she will make you believe that everything is possible in life. She is somebody who had sacrificed her job just for the sake of preparing for CAT, and she did it brilliantly well. So, we'll talk about a lot of factors as to what all factors influence your preparation and how it feels to be in IFT. And converting a lot of colleges, I must say, and picking one best college for your goal. We'll carry the interview forward, Aishi. So the first question which we'll have for us is, tell us something about your academics and your work experience.
Sir, I did my graduation in 2017. I'm a chemical engineer and I completed it from Punjab University, Chandigarh.
Great.
Post that, I worked for 2 years in oil and gas industry, Vedanta Limited. So there I worked as an area engineer, and it was working over there that I realized that yes, I have to take an MBA degree, and for growth opportunities that I have to move forward. And that's why I decided to quit my job, because I thought that I cannot manage both the things together. So I thought, why not focus, why not shift my focus completely to the MBA preparation so that I can get into one of the best colleges.
डर नहीं लगा तेरे को नौकरी छोड़ते समय कि नौकरी छोड़ देंगे और फिर पता नहीं क्या होगा होगा तो फिर क्या नहीं होगा तो क्या होगा बिकॉज लॉट ऑफ यू नो पीपल आर स्ट्रेस्ड अबाउट इट
हाँ सर, लगा था बहुत डर. इवन मेरे को बहुत लोगों ने बोला भी था कि आई एम मेकिंग अ रॉन्ग डिसीजन, आई शुड कंटिन्यू विद द जॉब और उसके साथ प्रिपरेशन करनी चाहिए. बट देन आई थॉट कि
ये कि आप कंटिन्यू करें अपने जॉब के साथ और फिर प्रिपेयर करते रहें साइड बाय साइड क्योंकि कोई भी ये नहीं कहता है कि अपनी जॉब छोड़ करके तैयारी करो देन बट यू टू बोल्ड स्टेप ऑफ क्विटिंग योर जॉब एंड देन प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर कैट व्हाट मोटिवेटेड यू टू टेक दैट स्टेप इट वाज एन एक्सट्रीम स्टेप आई मस्ट से एंड यू आर वर्किंग विद अ ब्रिलियंट कंपनी एट अ ब्रिलियंट पैकेज इफ आई रिमेम्बर वेल यस या
यस सर. सो सर, आई लेफ्ट दैट जॉब टू focus entirely on MBA, and I knew that अगर इस बार नहीं निकला तो आई डेफिनेटली डू समथिंग एल्स, और मैं अगले साल वापस से ट्राई करूंगी. बट आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू वेस्ट दैट एफर्ट कंटिन्यूइंग इन अ जॉब दैट आई वॉन्ट परस्यू फॉर अ लॉन्ग ड्यूरेशन. आई चोज द जॉब बिकॉज आई वॉन्टेड एक्सपीरियंस, बट देन दैट एक्सपीरियंस ओनली शिफ्ट डाइवर्टेड मी टूवर्ड्स MBA, बिकॉज नेवर इन माई लाइफ आई हैव थॉट आई वुड डू एन MBA. I
Correct.
was a technical person and I loved that. I never thought I'll go into management and marketing and sales and everything.
Right.
So I believe that that job helped me, identify where I want to go in life. So.
So working into energy sector, if I am right, you're working with energy sector and with at a very handsome package, quitting your job. Then where did this and a hardcore technical girl, how did you get into management? Like, what motivated you to get into MBA program? Because MBA is something which is usually related to commerce guys or people who want to get into business. And we hear from a lot of students that they don't want to compromise with their technical skills and hence they don't want to go with MBA program. But you being one of those girls who did it, how did you do that? And what motivated you? What motivated you for an MBA program? That's the question.
So, sir, I have seen my brother. He's also a computer science engineer. He worked with Infosys and then he was doing the MBA at that time. So, I've seen his growth. There is a 360 degree shift in a person's personality, in a person's way of thinking when you go for a degree like MBA. Because you just don't focus on the technicalities, you focus on each and every aspect of the business. And also, while I was in Kane, so I communicated with my managers. I was, in constant touch with different verticals of the organization, and I thought that yes, these are the peoples that inspire me to, go for an MBA degree, and maybe then I can be delivering the output that they are delivering right now. So correct. That was the motivation that I thought shifted me towards it.
So you were a working girl and then you left your job and came completely into studies. And I'm sure that when you are into working, you usually don't have this habit of studying. And then quitting your job and then studying, you know, carrying on your whole study thing again would be a challenge. So what challenges did you face during your CAT prep, if you can discuss a few with the audience?
So, sir, first, after quitting the job, I thought that maybe I'll go with the online courses that are available. But then I thought that it won't be consistent with my efforts and I'll be too lazy to study on my own. So I right. thought joining a coaching center would be the best option, because then, you know, it would be a daily, day-to-day routine job, and then the assignments would be given and then you have to do it. There is no yep. option left. Right. So in order to maintain that consistency, I chose the coaching classes, and I made sure that all the material that was provided by the coaching center, I do it. I didn't look for too many material. I just focused and did what was provided to me, because I believe that questions are same. It's just the speed and the tactics that, you know, matter the most.
Right.
So whatever the teachers taught in the class, whatever methods they taught, I just applied that. I didn't go searching on YouTube different tactics, because then I would be confused much more by myself.
Absolutely.
So I just focused on one technique. I brushed it. I modified it according to my needs and according to my, you know, if I'm slow in calculation, that I'll rounded the numbers and then maybe do the calculation in order to arrive at a result faster. So these all things were there that I changed. Also, I made a small group of friends who we used to study together in the coaching center after the So we were three girls who were studying together. So we really that, you know, push yourself to move forward and work together. So you are not alone in that journey.
One of those girls is in IIM Kashipur, I must say. Right? So the whole group did very well.
Yes, sir.
Great. So usually people have this, problem. Students, when they prepare for CAT, they have this problem that they are not able to maintain their regularity. You know, they study for 3 days and then they are not able to continue with the fourth day because of some odd reason in life, you know. And they got some celebration in family and they got busy for 3-4 days and then possibly they are not able to come back to studies, and then it takes like a week to again get into the same thing. So how did you maintain regularities in studies? Like, out of how many hours did you put in your, you know, put in your studies and on everyday basis? And how did you divide that, whatever time you allotted? Like, how did you divide that subject-wise?
So, sir, like all the engineering students out there, we have our verbal is a bit on a doomy side because we are good in quants, we are good in LRDI, but verbal is something that needs too much of hard work.
I remember crying over verbal scores a lot. After every mock, you would cry, right? So I remember that.
Yes. So that was the case with me also. So I tried to read newspaper. I tried to read novels, because that was the only thing that I thought would help me, you know, be consistent with the verbal ability part.
A very important question. Does reading help in VARC?
Sir, it may not. Means there are both the sides of it. So it increases the speed, definitely. And speed, it really helps when you're, reading the reading comprehensions in the exam. And the speed also helps you to, you know, speed also along with that, you understand that thing in one go. You don't have to, you know, go again and again in the same line.
The regression decreases.
What, sir?
The regression decreases, like you don't have to read the paragraph twice or twice.
Yeah. So, and plus, since I was not, you know, very much into reading and very much into verbal ability, I was not, that was not my area of interest. So, correct. In order to develop that interest, I had to first go by the route that was much more easier and much more interesting.
Hmm.
So a person who is good in reading, who has read novels throughout his life, who is good in verbal activity, can definitely skip that step, but the ones who are starting from the level zero, I should say that they should at least devote half an hour to 1 hour on this.
On reading exercises. That's very
yes, sir.
Wonderful. So all the students who are preparing for CAT this year, a very important tip from Maharishi, that you need to get into reading. There is no shortcut if at all you want to be very comfortable with reading comprehension. Right, Maharishi?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you were talking about how do you maintain regularity in studies. Yes.
So, you... so sir, the one of the major reason to join the coaching center was to maintain the regularity. Also, I tried to be in the top 1% of the students in my batch. Because whenever sir used to give us a question, it was like who will answer him the first and correctly. So that was a kind of challenge that I took on myself. And in order to deliver that result, I focus that I study on a regular basis. Whatever topic was completed in the class that day, I come back and do the exercise of that. And maybe the next day I can ask the doubts because it is fresh in mind. So you can ask as many doubts as possible. Also, it is not a procrastinating thing like I'll do it next day, I'll do it next day. So I made sure that I completed then and there only. Also, sir, since I had a very much pressure of, you know, leaving my job and coming into MBA, so that was also a pressure that I cannot waste my time and I cannot waste my effort. Because yes. I knew that 1 year gap is something that I won't be able to justify if I want to go again into a technical field.
Yes, yes, yes. And I remember
very difficult for me.
Traveling. I remember you traveling for almost 35, 40 kilometers to come for your GDPI lessons because you stay away from the GDPI center we had. We were conducting the GDPI lessons in Indranagar and you used to stay in somewhere like 40 kilometers away from that particular place. So you used to come there every day without fail. So that also showed the kind of regularity you maintained. And whenever we had some extra sessions in Aliganj or Indranagar session, you were always there. So you have to put in a lot if at all you want to have some great results.
So there should be a discipline in oneself that if you have thought that you have to achieve this, then at least you have to be disciplined and you have to work towards it. Then only you can expect the results to come out of it.
Absolutely.
So
absolutely.
Hard working is very important. And plus, when you see that there are, you know, many more like-minded people and many more, even more intelligent than you are fighting for those seats. So then it becomes a much more challenge.
Yes. And in your batch, especially, there were a lot of people like, you know, and we had so many converts that year because we got a very good bunch of students that year. Anyways, so how important do you think the mock tests are during preparation? Because usually students start writing mock paper after July and they think that once our whole course is completed, we'll start writing mock tests. So how do you, cater to this particular problem of the students?
So mock tests are very important. Means I cannot... coaching is zero without mock test. This is your whole preparation is zero without, you know, giving even at least a single mock test. No matter how bad you perform in a mock test, but after that, you have to, you know, spend 2-3 hours analyzing your mistakes and analyzing the gaps. Even a single, you know, silly mistake in quants can lead to a negative of 1 mark. So that is the kind and. Negative of 1 mark means losing 4 marks in total and it can, you know, decrease your rank to a greater extent it can. So you cannot choose to lose that 4 marks. And for that, it is very much important that you give mock test. It's good to fail in mock test than to fail in the, you know, the main exam.
We always explain. And ideally, when should students start taking mock tests? I think in the month of May, June is the right time, even if your course is not complete. That's what we believe in. Like, what is your
take? Yes, sir. In Funamakers, I remember that the mock test started after 2 months of my joining and like only 5-10% of the course was completed by then. And many of the students in my batch also, you know, didn't used to take the mock test thinking that the course is not complete. How can we take the mock test? But then there were another 25-50% of the students who used to give mock tests. And if you can see that the converts are maximum from those 50% students who were consistent with their mock tests, even when the course was not complete.
Correct.
So I myself remember, you know, the first mock test, I solved just 25% of the paper and rest of the paper was like, I don't know anything about it. I'm not going to solve it.
Right.
So I completed it in 1 hour, the 3 hour mock test I completed in 1 hour. But right. then slowly, slowly the marks increased and slowly, slowly we reached the target.
So what was your average score like throughout your mock tests if you talk about? Like you must have taken more than 30 mock tests if I remember, because 25.
I have taken all the mock tests.
All the mock tests from Fundamicus. Right. So what were your converts? All colleges did you convert?
So sir, I was, you know, in the verbal ability because of 0.2% of the weightage, I was not able to clear that section, particular section in CAT. Mm. So because of which I had missed my SPGEN, the call, I missed that.
Seeing your score in the initial days, you had a great improvement in VRC, but I think something went bad that day. You must not have.
Yeah, I chose the wrong sets, sir. In the pressure, I chose the wrong sets. And then the time was over.
Right.
Yeah.
So, what all colleges did you convert?
Sir, I converted IMT Ghaziabad, IMI Delhi, IIM Ranchi. I converted SCMHRD and IFT Delhi. Because I have only these calls. I had a call from VG Som as well.
You had programs also in pipeline.
Yes, sir. I had from IIM Kozhikode, IIM Lucknow, IIM Indore.
Correct.
And I'm Bangalore. Yeah.
I'm Bangalore. So why did you decide to go for IFT?
Sir, because I applied for the what I can say the FPM programs, thinking that I should be backed up with something in case, because I knew my CAT was wasted, means I didn't got a good score, so the baby IIMs also would not call me. So that's why I thought that maybe I should secure a seat in some of the FPM programs and maybe I can do a 5-year PhD program. Mm. But then when I converted IFT Delhi, sir, it was like one of top 10 B schools in the country. It is one of the top 10 B schools. So that was something. Also the fact that it gives an MBA in it gives a degree in MBA international business was something that attracted me, because it gives you exposure in trade, it gives you exposure in international business. So it not only just focuses on management but also on a broader aspect. So all the calls that I had, IFT Delhi was the best option.
So basically we can say that if your CAT if your CAT has not gone well, you must not stop and you should not lose hope, because there are other exams in India which can give you a brilliant opportunity to get into the top-notch colleges in India again, like IFT we have SAT also, we have TISNET also. So it is like people usually think that my CAT is ruined and then my life is over for that particular year. So that is a misconception, right? We need to understand that every exam is a different exam and there's always an opportunity to do well in other exams if at all you have failed in the first exam. Because
I remember there was just a week gap between the CAT exam and the IFT exam.
Right.
So once you know that your CAT, you have failed badly in CAT, it becomes very difficult, you know, to gather that strength again and go for the other exams.
Absolutely.
But then you have to do it because it's just a matter of 1 week or a matter of one whole year. So
exactly. A single bad day cannot decide your life. So we need to get up with same energy next day and try to do something better. Yeah, absolutely. So you proved it, right? You did not have a great CAT score, still you did wonderfully well in IFT. So that proves that you should never be giving up. All right. So once you are now, when you are now into IFT, I just have this question. I'm sure this question is with a lot of students. Like, if somebody converts the new IIMs and you know, new IIMs versus IFT, how do you rate?
Sir, I believe that I would rate IFT above the new IIMs, because I believe that IFT has a huge legacy. of 60 years, and that's not a very short legacy. That's a good legacy to hold itself within the market, to hold itself within the top B schools in the country. People recognize IIT Delhi. Mm-hmm. Even the good companies, we have the alum base spread to huge company, to all the companies. We have CEOs in major companies. So this is the alum base, the pedagogy, the culture, the heritage, and the, you know, the entire education culture of IIT Delhi was something that I would say is on a better level as compared to the new IIMs that are coming in.
What kind of exposure do people get into IIT? Like, what are the clubs? For example, a student, a new student who wants to join IIT, what all things he should be, looking at? Like, what all facilities? Not facilities, in fact. We are not talking about facilities. We are talking about exposure. What kind of extracurricular activities happen? What is the pressure of studying? What is a normal day like in an IIT?
So, sir, in IIT, you'll see people, you'll see students from all backgrounds in the terms of their educational background. You'll see a commerce student, you'll see a person who has, spent 4 years preparing for UPSC and then he has given IIT and then coming. There are people who have left 5 years of job, well-paid job, in order to, get into IIT. So there is a huge cultural diversity that you get to meet in IIT. Mm-hmm. Also, there are different clubs, cells, and committees. For trade, we have one committee, one club. For marketing, we have one. So depending upon your interest, you can participate in these club, cells, and committees. And, they... on a regular basis, they interact with the people. They teach us also. They held various knowledge sessions for us so that we can be prepared for our internships as well as for our final placements. Also, once anyone enters IIFT, so before the actual joining, the seniors usually, they train you as to how your life would be for the next 2 years in IIFT. That is like a transition. Earlier, you used to study.
That is the most important piece of learning when you get in an MBA college. The first 6 months train you the best.
Yes, sir, definitely. Yeah. So there would be many presentations that you have to make. There would be many, you have to upskill yourself on a regular basis because your peer group would be doing the same. So in order to, it is like a fight. You have to be on the top, but there is a positive competition. You have to take your peer group together with yourself. No person can complete an MBA alone. A person can complete an MBA only with this peer group. So,
well said, well said.
Yeah, so these are the, that you have to be, MBA teaches you everything, sir, I believe that. How to work in groups, how to, respect each other's ideas, how to look for solutions instead of problems. And correct. How to deliver the best result in a limited amount of time. So it's an exposure in itself, a life exposure in itself.
Correct, correct. So a lot of people, usually have this misconception that if you have bad scores in 10th and 12th, then your life is doomed. So as an IFTN, how would you cater to that?
No, sir, not at all. Luckily, I had good scores. But I also got friends who didn't have that great score, but they are in the top 5% of the people who converted IIFTs. So it's not just your educational background that matters. What matters is how you are doing efforts, to bring something on the table that can nullify that effect. For example, if you're bad, if you had scored bad in 10th and 12th, get yourself a good score in IIFT. Nobody would ask you why you got a bad score in 10th.
What I always explain to students, yeah.
Yeah. Even if you had, there must be some reason why. And it is very much important that you be honest. Even if you didn't study in your 10th and 12th, there should be no shame in saying to the interviewer that I was not, that much into studies at that time. But at the same time,
mature enough to do brilliantly well at 16 or 18 years of age. So how do you expect everybody to have great scores? So it's okay if you don't have a good score in 10th and 12th.
Not everyone has, sir. The same is the case with IFT score, sir. My IFT score was on the line. Like it was...
I remember.
It was just on the line. It was like... many people said that
right?
I won't be able to convert.
138, I believe, right?
Yeah. 135 was the cutoff and I was on 138.
Yes. Yeah, I remember that, right? Because we talked about it so much that these numbers were seeded in my mind. And I still remember you right after the IFT, you know, interview, you called me and you said that these were the questions and this is how I handled those questions. I remember that very well, yeah. So, people usually are going for skill improvement, you know, they are going for certifications in finance and, you know, sort of, I mean, a 4-hour workshop in marketing or a 5-hour workshop in, HR. Do you think it adds value to a student's learning curve?
So during the preparation of the CAT, they are going for the certifications. Sir, I believe that if it is not hampering with their preparation, then there is no harm in it because it would give them an exposure. And not every college gives you an opportunity to choose your majors or your subjects in the second year. In many colleges, you have to make your mind whether you want to go for marketing or finance. And many people are not, you know, confident about which stream they have to choose. So if you are confused with that, then there is no harm in trying for these short life projects or these short stints so that you can, you know, better understand where your interest lies. But then again, it should not hamper with your studies that you are doing. You have to manage both.
But it's good to have an idea about all the subjects before you go for an MBA program. That really helps, I think.
So even if you don't have, I don't believe that there is a disadvantage.
Because of Corona, the moment you took admission in IFT, Corona hit and then everything went online. So, and I'm sure a lot of dreams have shattered, but still I would like to talk about it. So online versus in-campus MBA, what do you miss? What is the pros? What is the cons? If you can talk about it, because students are confused this year whether they should join MBA or not in online. So yeah, your take on it.
So we would have not missed anything if our seniors or the friends who have already done MBA have, you know, shared photos and everything with us, then we would have not missed anything. But right now, the hostel life is the biggest thing that we have missed, the life after classes, outside classrooms. But then online MBA is also in itself a new education thing that emerged in the COVID times. The teams have become our classrooms and the Zoom calls have become our, areas where we discuss with our peer groups and, you know, participate in various competitions and we prepare together for the exams or for other interviews and everything. So, I believe that one should not defer his MBA thinking that it is an online mode. If one is getting an opportunity to enter into a good MBA school, then he should definitely join that school. Because whatever pedagogy that is being taught in an offline mode is being, you know, delivered in the online mode as well. We have case studies, we have interactions. We have the same kind of pedagogy. In terms of peer learning, yes, we cannot meet with our peers, you know, 24/7, but we are connected most of the time through Zooms or through Telegram and whatnot. So even the activities like the club cells and committees, they have conducted all the activities that are to be conducted for the academic year. We even had the section wars, virtual games we had this year. So it was a new experience.
I have been seeing a lot of banners being publicized. So
it is something. So it's the new normal and people are coming up with greater and bigger ideas. So I believe that.
And I think
one should experience this also.
I think you cannot put this aside thinking that, we will get into education only when things normalize. Because I think this is the new normal and a lot of things will be happening in this mode only because things have changed their way. things have shaped themselves as per the need of the hour, and that was online thing. So I think companies have gone online, services have gone online. So why not education? Like, there's no problem. So what are the placements like? You know, because that's a big question. Placements, people are really worried about placements. I'm investing 20, 25 lakhs. What about placements? So what is the average placement goes like? And what kind of companies, don't name the companies, but what kind of industries are coming to, you know, IFT?
So, all the students out there who want to look for, so the IFT has released its placement report as well as the summer internship report on the portal. So they can check that out. The placements were at par with what used to happen in the previous years as well. So the average package was 21 plus lakh per annum. And all the top companies, all the top brands that used to visit earlier, they visited this year as well. So
very handsome salary package. Yeah. I must say.
And highest package was 46 lakh, sir. So,
wonderful.
Yeah. Only the mode of interview, the mode of conducting the entire process changed, the mode of interaction changed, but the job profiles, the salary and everything were the same. So we used to have the virtual GDs, we used to have interviews online. So only this part of the process changed.
Correct. So I think people out there who think that IFT, if you join in online mode, also putting in 20, 21 lakhs in online mode, is it worth it or not? So what is your answer to those people? Is it absolutely okay, or there is a risk factor?
Sir, only the, I believe that in terms of if a person wants to learn and if a person wants to, you know, grasp as much from an MBA college, he can grasp it in an online mode as well. The only factor that he won't be able to live is his hostel life. That's it.
Correct.
Rest, if he's too much into hostel life, you know, he can sacrifice 2 years of his life.
Nahin,
sir, hota hai hostel life ka, humko bhi craze hai. But the thing is, we cannot waste 1 year of our career for that hostel life.
Correct.
So you have to prioritize one thing over the other.
Right.
So aisa nahi hai ki if you will be in online, there would be lesser opportunities. The opportunities would be even more. There would be more live projects that you can take simultaneously. There would be more, you know, competitions that you can participate in. So it just depends on what you prioritize and how you manage your day.
Wonderful. Wonderful. So last question. How did Fundamakers help you?
So, sir,
how have been Fundamakers a part of your journey throughout life?
So, in the starting, as I mentioned, that I was looking for a coaching center. So, Fundamaker was at that time in the initial stage, and I thought that there were two options in front of me, the other coaching center and Fundamaker. So, I thought that since it is new, there are less number of students, so there would be more focus on each student. And also, it is one of the branch was closer to my house, so I thought that the traveling time would be reduced, so it would be great for me. Okay. So I joined Fundamaker without having any second thought. The teachers were great. Each and every center stands out in itself. I remember that we used to have, after every mock test, we used to, you know, see which center topped that mock and who is the student who topped from that center.
Yes.
Yeah. So, There used to be analysis of the mock, post the mock. So that was one great thing. Also, whenever we used to, you know, wanted to have a extra class on some of the topics, it was arranged. Even if there were 2-3 people, it was arranged for them. So, and it Fundamakers really helped me to be consistent with my performance. They helped me from the starting where I didn't knew anything about MBA, to the place where I was filling the forms, to the place where I was preparing for the GDPI, and till I, you know, converted the call. So it was during that entire 1 year it was with me.
Correct.
So
you also, I must say, like, you, we as teachers are blessed to have students like you, because you people have really made us proud. It's not like only students need good coaching students. Good coaching students also need brilliant students. And it is a give and take policy. I mean, any coaching institute cannot be a good coaching institute unless there's an amalgamation of good teachers and good students together. So I think you have surpassed every expectation of a good student. You have been very disciplined. You have been constantly into doubt solving sessions. You have been so regular and put in so much work during your GDPI lessons that this conviction makes us so proud. The whole Fundamakers family is very proud of you. And I will not like to take a lot of time because I know that you are busy. You are into your online session, and you have squeezed some time out for this this particular interview from your very busy schedule. So I don't want to take this interview very long. But we have discussed so many questions. We have discussed almost every question which newbie students who is getting into preparation would have a doubt about. And we are so thankful that you have carved out this time to guide the juniors in Fundamakers, to people who are now preparing for CAT and trying to get into the top B schools. You have guided them so well. Thank you so much for this. Thank you so much for this.
Thank you, sir. It is a pleasure to always, come back and maybe tell these students what we did and not to do the things that, we did and were wrong.
Well, we are thinking of putting all the students on a Zoom call with you, and then they will, fire you with a lot of questions. So that will be a very interesting session. So we'll be doing that soon.
Any day.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for doing this. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.